Hello, everyone, and Merry Christmas. This has always been a special day for my family. We usually get together to eat too much food, including birthday cake, share laughs and stories, watch cheesy holiday movies, give each other gifts, and most importantly, spend quality time together. This time of year is supposed to be full of joy, light, and family traditions. But this Christmas is different. Families aren't getting together for big dinners, and friends aren't stopping by for cookies and eggnog. This isn't the holiday season we wanted, I know. But here's the thing. Even though this year's Christmas traditions will be different, we can and should give thanks for everything that unites us. Because today is a time to recognize all the good that we have in our lives. It's a time to celebrate Christ's message of compassion and show people that we love them. And that message has never been more important. We can all agree that 2020 has been a tough year. But through it, we've seen Canadians meet these challenging times with generosity, kindness, and hope. We've seen neighbors helping neighbors, kids giving up playdates and birthday parties, businesses retooling to help in the fight against COVID-19, and we've seen our frontline workers put themselves at risk to keep us safe and our families fed. This year, everyone has done their part, because that's who we are. As Canadians, we show up for each other. And that's what Christmas and Canada is all about. My friends, this crisis will end. And as a country, we will come out of it stronger and more united. So today and into the new year, let's continue to stand together. Let's support folks in need in our communities, and let's reach out to our friends and neighbors who may be having a tough time. From our family to yours, Hadrian, Ella Grace, Xavier, Sophie, and I wish you joy, health, and love this holiday season and beyond. Merry Christmas, Canada.